Hello friends, my name is Palash and today's presentation is all about corrective and preventive actions called as CAPA. This major presentation has been divided into a three part, and please listen carefully. All are very important and I have tried to explain on all the aspects of CAPA management system. And if you are really willing to learn, willing to understand this process, you should listen up to the end of this video. The content I have created with the help of FDA, WHO and ICH guidance, so those are very important. You should read all those lines and you should understand carefully. Part 1, we have discussed about the different kind of definitions around the CAPA. Part 2, we discuss about management review and how you should present the data to the management, and how CAPA is all about your life cycle of your product, that you will understand in part 2. And part 3 will cover the case study and you will understand how to implement the CAPAs and how to derive from an incident or a part of non-conformance, how to derive a corrections, corrective actions, effectiveness check and preventive actions, and those we'll cover in this case study 1 and case study 2. So before starting the main presentation, I would like to request you all to subscribe my channel PRES, Pharmaceutical Resource and Education Services, and press the bell icon to get notification of my all upcoming videos. Thank you very much. Let's begin the presentation of CAPA, corrective and preventive actions. So we'll understand what is CAPA as per ICH-Q10. So a structural approach actually, and when you do investigations and as a part of outcome, so you will get the root cause. So the few people, they will discuss that every investigation is required to have a root cause. So of course not, but probably the intentions of the investigation, we should identify the most desirable cause. And whenever you are correcting those most desirable cause, that will be called corrective actions. So the actions which will eliminate the cause actually, right? So whichever you have detected in the non-confirmatory is considered as corrective actions. And preventive is you are potentially identifying all the non-confirmatory which can cause the event, and the problem may arise in your process. So it is undesirable, all potential situation and all non-confirmatory need to be addressed through preventive actions. So furthermore, if we split these corrective actions, we can come through a couple of words like corrections. So correction, I will tell, it is a first instance. Corrections or remedial actions, it focus on the immediate situations and eliminate the existing non-conformance. That is called corrections. And when we call corrective actions, a corrective actions is a reaction to a non-conformatory or undesirable situation that already happened. And what is preventive? The preventive is the approach and the process of detecting non-conformatory or undesirable situation that have not yet happened, right? Have not even happened. We just want to prevent their occurrence in future. And so we need to identify all the potential area where we should act on, right? So I think from this slide, we are clearing three things: corrections, which is the remedial actions, we are closing the condition, the situation, what is occurring. Corrective actions, again, this is the reactions for a non-conformatory or undesirable situations that already happened. We're trying to rectify that. So maybe couple of actions that we need to take that may not be immediate, that takes some time, but that should to be determined based on the patient safety and process safety, how much time we could spare for a corrective actions. And preventing yet not happen, those area where you have identified and you want to prevent before occurrence, right? So we'll go next and discuss more about that. So The root cause investigation process is a key step of handling major and critical deviations, right? So our intent will be identify a potential root cause. Unless you will identify a potential root cause, it may be one, it may be multiple sometime, right? Whenever we are not quite sure that this will be your potential root cause, sometime we assume these are maybe 2, 3, 4 maybe associate with the failure. So anyhow, we need to identify the root cause. So that is the way we can, you know, identify the problem and we can rectify. And otherwise, this is if there is no root cause identified potentially, the chances of reoccurrence is very high. And it will provide objective evidence to implement corrective and possibly preventive as a part of CAPA system. So you will have suitable CAPA system as a part of your policies, quality policy and quality system. So it may be electronic way of doing, you know, CAPA. It may be a hard documented process. So both are possible to be adopted. So corrective actions are taken to eliminate the root cause, as we discussed, of deviation, and should to be based on a good quality investigation. So later on, probably we'll have I'll try to generate few slides on how to build good quality investigations. Here we'll not discuss more. We'll go ahead with corrective and preventive actions. What is our today's topic? So corrective action should to be approved by QA, right? So it should be assessed by the QA before implementing. Before implementation, right? So it should be approved by the QA. Their efficacy verified in a documented manner. Activity that could require a significant period of time, right? So these are the activity are pre-populated, because you need to provide a time when you trying to improve that. Why what bother you, because you have kept a 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 1 month or 6 month timeline. Whether any impact on your process, product, patient, safety. So that require assessment from the quality perspective, right? Corrective actions could be transferred to independent CAPA system to avoid unnecessary delay or deviation closure, right? So it may happen you would like to close your deviation report, non-conformance report, and the CAPA. What you have proposed, if still open, you cannot able to close the report. So it is recommended you can have a independent CAPA system where we can assign some numbers and we can give in certain reference of this number in the deviation closure, and you can close the deviation. So this independent CAPA system should to be tracked for all the actions required by pre-approved CAPA plan and effectiveness check, right? So whenever you have a list of CAPA which has been placed in a tracking system, you should have effectiveness check of every individual CAPA upon implementations, and it should to be pre-approved plan, right? So whenever there is a plan, it should to be defined timeline when we are going to perform those corrections or preventive actions, and that should to be verified upon completion. So that is called effectiveness check. Not all corrective actions will have associated preventive actions. It may possible your all corrective actions may not have preventive action. It's not necessary you should have preventive along with all corrective, right? So I'm just trying to clarify it, that don't be confused. So it may happen your corrective actions and your preventive actions moving together, and you have identified an issue, from that you have done corrections, corrective action, and preventive are proposed. But it is not always compulsorily you have always have a preventive actions with the corrective actions. It may possible sometime you will not have. Corrective actions are reactive in nature and triggered in response to detect deviations, and could generate preventive action as well. So as we discussed, those are reactive. We correct when we found some correction is required based on some findings. Which we call as non-conformatory or deviations or non-conformance, whatever the word you want to choose. These preventive actions will act on similar process manufacturing lines and different site where there has not been yet deviation. So this is very important. Whenever you found something has happened to your line, process, plant, you should evaluate for the similar one. And that's how preventive action is very important. You should holistically assess whether any chance of failure, similar failure in your one of the different line or one of the manufacturing side, it may happen. The site is not placed nearby you, it is far away, but it should to be holistically assessed. So some failure you have observed, that failure should not to be reoccur some XYZ or different site, right? So that is the power of Kappa we are trying to discuss today and we are trying to implement in our system. Hopefully it has been clear how these corrective and preventive actions need to be, you know. So in this slide we'll be able to know how the Kappa system drives in our industry. So it is majorly manufacturing focused or patient safety focused. So when we are talking about manufacturing focus, so it, as we discussed, is derived from deviations, NCs, annual product reviews, management reviews, complaint, risk management, validations. So as a part of outcome, we can propose Kappas for the improvement. And again, it can be patient-centric. So in kind of safety, or effectiveness or something which is impacting the patient risks, so we can propose suitable Kappa based on that. So this Kappa sometimes come up with the strong financial requirement and commitment as well. Whenever we are talking about certain regulatory compliance or certain commitment we give to regulatory auditors, and that required some pre-populated timeline, and you should stick on that timeline strictly. So the understanding of the management, agreement of the management, if it is required to raise a fund, investment of sufficient fund. So the involvement of senior management is very high in this regards, and the management should have all clarities what need to be done, what need to be performed. And once this clarity is given and agreed upon both the parties, regulators, sites, management, and plant shop floor teams or plant management, so it's required to have occasional meeting to present all the data so it can be visualized how things are moving. So I will show my next slide. So we can have certain visual indicators which will show the progress of Kappa. It may be we can track the online closure, we can track whether it is overdue, we can track how many non-conformance we are having, what are the category of non-conformance we are having. So whether delay in any kind of closure of all those proposed timeline, based on that proposed timeline, if something is delayed, that need to be tracked, and properly Kappa extension plan need to be initiated, and some extension if required, then feasible date should to be identified as a part of extension. Something negotiating with the product quality and safety may not be appreciable, so we should close, we should target all those Kappa as soon as possible. Although we should take some restrictive actions, or maybe sometime hold the batch or stop the manufacturing line if you need some significant time to rectify those. Future of Kappa is more proactive rather than reactive. So the expectation is you improve your system before if you identify some failure. So maybe some data trend shows that you are going to fail, or something need to be improved on, and you should proactively touch on that. And as a part of continuous improvement project, suppose you are going to move from manual process to automatic process, and you can have that kappa, and you can improve your quality system, you can improve your maintenance system. So it's better for before failure, we should actively work on that. And sometimes happen the industry regulations updated, and we should more vigilant, and we should understand what are the requirement of the regulations, and something we are not meeting, and that should to be comply through a kappa system. So anyhow, as a part of cost of quality model, anything and everything which is impacting your quality and you need to improve on, and that should to be correct approach should to be there. And before failure, you should approach with some kappa, and that should to be implemented as a part of system. Implementing kappa earlier in a development process is well appreciable. As per the ICH Q10 recommendations, kappa applies on product life cycle. So now we will here discuss and understand a different approach of kappa system. So till now we are talking about reactive mechanism of kappa, where we act upon failure. We talk about proactive nature of using this kappa management system, where we should identify the opportunity before it fails. So probably we discuss on this two scenario. One is post failure, one is before failure, to preventing any kind of occurrence in future. So here the recommendation of ICHQ 10, it should apply during the development phase, when your product is getting developed, whatever the kappa methodology that should to be applied to monitor and control all the improvements during the development. Although when development to it switching for a technology transfer, while you're transforming the technology from your R&D to manufacturing facility. So kappa can be a very efficient system to get all those feedback and feed forward and continual improvement process we can track as a part of this system. As a part of commercial manufacturing, so it is a very efficient system during the entire manufacturing life cycle till you discontinue that product. So whatever the improvement, you should track with kappa system, and an effective actions evaluated in your system, and that should to be reviewed as a part of your kappa closure. And it propose till product discontinuations, you should apply the kappa. So how it is related with the product discontinuation? Kappa should to be continue after the product discontinuation as well. Why? The impact of the product remaining on the market should to be considered, right? So certain kappa you have taken, that can have impact on your marketed product as well. So till last unit of your product is exist on the market, you should follow this kappa. So now end up that this presentation, we able to understand not proactive, not reactive. It should embed it from our system once we started the R&D activity and once we have disconnected the product, right? So this is the whole life cycle of kappa management system. So here we will discuss a simple case study to understand how these corrective and preventive actions are applied to any kind of investigations. So it's just an example. We have just trying to show you how it is different and how it can be derived from any kind of outcome of investigations. So the case study one is, so operator hand is burned, he touches the hot surface of the equipment by mistake. Right. So let's see what are the kappa we can propose. So initially the corrective actions we took that we put a board, we put a visual board over there mentioning that the surface is hot and people should not touch that. And as a part of corrective actions, the hot surface is insulated externally to avoid any kind of human contact. And as a part of extended holistic assessment, the engineering head given instruction to all the people, all the maintenance team, that they should identify all that potential areas or hot surfaces in the equipment, and that need to be considered for the insulation. And as a part of preventive action, engineering procedure to be revised to check that the insulation are done at the time of installations wherever it's required. And finally, effectiveness check has been carried out, whether to review that whether all actions whatever proposed at about of these corrective and preventive actions are closed successfully. So this is a very simple example why we have demonstrated corrections, corrective actions, preventive actions, and effectiveness check. Second example, so during an internal inspection, the sort of cells inspection, it was observed that the clock timing are different in two areas. So the different timings has been observed. This observation shared to production supervisor because it can have an extended impact on the data integrity or data reliability issue. The corrections, so clock timing was corrected, and as a part of corrective actions, all such clocks are identified from the area and correction performed manually. Preventive actions propose auto updating features are enabled with server clock to prevent such occurrence in future. Effectiveness check. So implementation of all the actions has been reviewed as a part of CAFA effectiveness check and found successfully completed. So these are the basic two simple example we have discussed here for better understanding. Thank you very much.